Welcome back to In the Hype with your boy ALX. We are back with another one. Today, I have a very special trailer reaction. It's for Love, Death, and Robots Volume 2. Okay, the first Love, Death, and Robots was a masterpiece. It was a masterpiece. Honestly, it was one of the best things I think Netflix has ever gotten behind. It is one of the best anthology series to ever come out. It's dark, it's light, it's beautiful, it's sad. You know, it makes you feel so much. And when I turned it on back when it came out, I just couldn't help but to just I journeyed through the whole thing, and it was a journey. The animation styles, top notch. Like some of the stuff was just so just immaculate, you know. And you know, the different styles of animation, I love how they came together and they told these separate stories with these different themes about life and what it means to be alive, what it means to be human. Those themes were just amazing. Shout out to, I think the short is called Zima Blue. That one, it really touched me. That one was the one that really got me. And it's crazy enough, it's the one that doesn't have, like, the big budgeted CGI. Like, it's the stripped back one. And that's the beauty of this show, you know. That's the beauty of this. So, without further ado, let's get into this. And if you like the content that you're seeing, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. It helps me out. It helps the channel out a lot, and I appreciate it. Okay, so let's get into this, and we will be breaking this down afterwards.
Don't you?
Wow. It's like a kind of door opens up out there. I figure it leads to some other world.
He's doing it again.
Trapped inside our own.
Why give all this up?
Score.
Why? I've been alive 218 years. I've seen too much.
Stop motion. Or the frame. Aww. May 14th. Oh! Oh! Oh, Netflix, man. Netflix. Yo. Oh! Volume 3 next year. Wasting no time, because I believe that this has been like a 2-year gap between this season and the last, probably because of the pandemic, maybe. But yo, it just feels like it takes so much work to create these seasons, you know what I mean? Because the crafting of it, if they can do anything close, and honestly, visually, I'm seeing some shit that's looking like it's, you know, it might be topping the first one. And the first one is a 10 out of 10 masterpiece. I don't care what anyone says. 10 out of 10 masterpiece, okay? This, visually, this trailer is getting a 10 out of 10. It's getting a 10 out of 10. But storytelling, that's the meat and potatoes of these shorts. It's the life lessons, the quirkiness, the abstractness, the what the fuckness, you know what I mean? The favorite, the things that you love the most about your favorite directors. Love, Death, and Robots has an amalgamation of all of those things. You know what I mean? So let's break it down a little bit. This opening shot right here, very sad, very sad. Somebody is like terminally ill. Homeland. And it just, oh man, and you could tell that these are made by real directors, man. How they sit on shots and let emotions linger, let the breath. It's beautiful. Absolutely.
You feel something.
The rain, the particle effects. Oh my God. Beautiful. The reflections coming from the car windshield as he sits and the camera zooms in. Yo, come on.
Don't you?
You see it? Wow. Oh my God, Fantasia 2000. Me, please.
It's like a kind of door opens up out there.
And I love this one too, man. I don't know what any of these are about, man. But it's just, it's beautiful. Sometimes the only issue you might have with some of these are you wish that they were longer. You know what I mean? Some of these stories, and I felt that with the first one, but I always felt like they ended it on a great note, even though I wish some of these stories could have been longer.
Some other world. That's trapped inside our own.
Oh my God, that music, the synth notes with this shot right here. You know what it's giving. You know what this is giving. Blade Runner 2049. it looks like it's taking direct inspiration from that, in my opinion. That, come on.
Why give all this up?
Why? Elysium. That gave me Elysium vibes. This shot right here is just so Pixar. But so next level, you know what I mean? Oh my God, just the small details, the emotion.
I've been alive 218 years.
Oh my God. And I've heard some people argue when the first one came out, yo, these just look like video game cutscenes. The best, get it straight, they look like the best video game cutscenes, okay? Not just any video game cutscene.
Years I've seen.
I said stop motion on this scene. But I it's just the frames. I don't think it's stop motion, but they use the that frame rate to beautiful use right here.
Too much.
Beautiful. And then we get these shots. That shot of that foot is iconic. I don't care. It's me. This shot. Oh my goodness gracious. why does this look so epic? It's just a foot and like a guy's that looking up at it. It's beautiful. And honestly, we can't break it down because we don't know what we're getting into. It's like it's a bag of mysteries we want to go into and not knowing much. We don't want to speculate. Great. That was a great shot. When he put the hand through the chest, that was great. Okay. Is that who I thought it was? Ladies and gentlemen, enter Michael B. Jordan. CGI Michael B. Jordan. I know he had a ball doing this. Wow. That's just cranking. Oh my God. Oh.
It's just what I wanted.
Yes. The kid spoke to me right there. He spoke to me right there. It's everything that I wanted. Volume 3, 2022. Man, Netflix, man. As a fan of this show, as a fan of this anthology series, I thank you from the bottom of my heart, because storytelling like this matters so much. Stories about what it means to be a human, what it means to not be a human. You know what I mean? It's crazy. And I love it. This has been ALX in the Hype, and we will be back.